Take one.
Is it hard for you to say those words? We're trying to cure cancer.
That's a really good question. Why it's hard to say we want to cure cancer. We do. And I think sometimes it's hard actually to think that you might actually succeed.
Patients that we're treating on this clinical trial have absolutely no other options left for them. These are patients who are unfortunately destined to die of their disease and in a fairly short amount of time.
Emily Whitehead, 554.
So Emma is incredibly matter-of-fact about all of this stuff. This was a child who had had her leukemia come back twice. The parents were looking for a miracle.
What we've learned how to do is train the immune system to recognize and then kill tumor cells.
It's a procedure where we collect their T cells, and they're infected with a virus that will genetically change them so that they will now see and react against their leukemia cells.
And we actually use the HIV virus to do that.
So you're taking the HIV virus and infecting healthy cells with it to help kill cancer?
Yes. The virus has been engineered so that it can't cause disease anymore. But it still retains the ability to reprogram the immune system so that it will now attack cancer cells. We call those modified immune cells serial killer cells. Each infused cell can kill more than 1,000 different tumor cells.
But the reality is the dramatic responses of cancer to new treatments are very unusual. We need to make it clear when we talk to a family that it may not work. Emma was given her T-cell treatment, and within a few days, she was very sick. She had breathing difficulties, she had blood pressure difficulties. We knew that she could not have gotten any sicker without actually dying.
But then a remarkable thing happened. The T cells were growing, they were starting to fight the cancer.
Within hours, Emma's fever disappeared.
It was like the calm after the storm. The clouds went away, and she woke up, and there was no leukemia. When that child survived, it was, of course, an amazing event.